Chuck Barris stages in Hollywood, California. It's The Dating Game. Here's the star of the show and your host, Jim Lang.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, and welcome once again to The Dating Game. Well, it's time to meet our first three eligible bachelors for game number one, and here they are.
Oh, that's so cute. Bachelor number one has won an Emmy and a Clio, and he's a very talented writer who unwinds by skin diving, hang gliding, and playing checkers, and he is Bill Taub. Bill, welcome. Bachelor number three is a comedian who loves listening to the radio, watching TV, and watching birds. And he's known for his ability to walk on a tightrope and do trapeze work. Meet Pee-wee Herman. And tennis, jogging, skiing, baseball, and women with an incredible sex drive are bachelor number three's hobbies. A salesman whose goal is to make lots of money, please welcome Bill Goldstein. Billy. And it's time now to meet our young lady. She's been in our soundproof booth for game number one, and here she is. All right. This lovely lady describes herself as a wild and crazy kind of a girl. She's won awards for her baton twirling as a former contestant from Ted Mack's original Amateur Hour. Let's say hello to the dynamite, Carrie Fry. Hello, Carrie. Ted Mack's Amateur Hour. Twirl your baton?
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
Did you win?
No, I didn't.
Well, I tell you, you can't lose today. Absolutely not. There are three bachelors over there. One of them will be your date anyway. The decision is totally yours after you've asked some questions, okay? We'll start with a hello and just see how they sound. Number one, would you give a nice hello to Carrie, please?
I'm very glad you asked me that. I'd like to make this perfectly clear. Hello.
We finally got him on the show, Carrie. All right. How about number two?
Hi, Carrie.
And number three?
Hello, Carrie. I feel super. How do you feel?
Okay. Well, Carrie, that gives you a little idea what they sound like. Now, stay right here and think about those voices, and we'll be back to play game number one right after these words. Welcome back to The Dating Game, Carrie. Those were interesting hellos, indeed. You had a little time to think about them. Now, shall we get on with the game?
Sure should.
All right, have a seat then. Make yourself comfortable there. Good luck, bachelors, because one of you is going to be very happy. Good luck. Here we go.
Okay, guys, you ready?
Yes.
Yep.
Bachelor number one, what's the first thought that comes to your head when you hear the word hot?
When I hear the word hot, I think of summer, I think of beaches, I think of sand, I think of rolling in the sand, and I think of sweating a lot.
All right, you're coming from the same place I am. Number two, what's the first thought that comes to your mind when you hear the word go?
When I hear the word go, I think about when I was taking traffic school lessons and when I was driving in my car and going real fast in my little Volkswagen bus and speeding down the street real fast and trying to get over to your house.
Okay, number three, how about the word stop?
Stop. It had to be a date when I was about 16 years old, and the girls kept saying,
stop,
stop, stop. Stop.
And what did you do?
I kept trying.
You kept
going.
Okay. Bachelor number two. I can't stand it when a guy's too easy. How are you going to make things tough for me?
Well, for one thing, I'm going to wear a bodysuit underneath my clothes.
That is a challenge, though, isn't it? How about you, number one?
I'm sorry, what was the question?
I can't stand it when a guy's too easy. How are you going to make things hard for me?
I can be bought. It's going to cost
you
money.
Bought? I don't have that much money. Okay, when I go out and I get really crazy, I start to howl. Bachelor number three, let's hear your best howl.
Down.
Bachelor number one, what does your sexiest outfit look like?
I'm wearing it.
You're wearing it? Well, I can't see it.
It's open all the way down.
Do you have any clothes on?
Yes.
Okay.
Shoes, socks.
Okay. Let's all regress back to our childhood now, okay? Baby number three, what have you got waiting for me in your playground?
The cutest little sucker and a little thing that swirls around on the top of my crib. We'll have so much fun with that. It's incredible.
What is a little sucker?
Well, the sucker's a happy face sucker for us. It's a share.
Okay, how about you, number two?
Well, I have one of those little battery-operated toy dogs that you push the button and it yaps, whoop, 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 and stuff like that.
Like one of those monkeys that goes like this, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's their faces.
Okay. Okay, bachelor number one, what's the best plan of action you're going to take after you've accidentally stepped on a lady at the beach?
After I have accidentally stepped on a lady at the beach,
right.
I am going to try and get up and run away as fast as I possibly can.
You're going to just run away from her without any explanation
absolutely.
Or any apology?
None whatsoever. It's all her fault for being there.
Oh. Well, excuse me. Okay. Bachelor number three, what's the silliest thing you've ever felt compelled to do and have done to a lady?
To a lady?
Mm-hmm.
Well, now, when I was about 17 years old, we were driving along the street, and we were talking about hanging what they call some things out the window. And she said, "You can't do that," so I did it in the car. How about that? Silly enough?
Okay. Bachelor number two, what's your best used line for your come on to any girl in a bar?
Hi, baby. You know, I might not be old enough to drink, but you look like you're old enough to drink.
Boy,
so
I'm running away right now.
That moment when you have to tell us which one of those marvelous bachelors will get a date with you. Now, will it be bachelor number one, bachelor number two, or bachelor number three? Who's the lucky fellow?
Bachelor number one.
Number one! All right. Well, would you tell us about your elimination? How did you end up with number one?
Because I liked his Hal. It sounds like he's got a call in the wild.
All right. Well, you see his outfit. Oh, well. You didn't choose number two, and you didn't choose number three. And I would like you to meet them right now, because they'd love to meet you. Number two is a comedian. He loves music. He loves watching birds. He's also a trapeze artist and a tightrope walker. Believe it or not, here he is, the incomparable Pee-wee Herman. Love it, Pee-wee. Just love it. Great outfit. You also didn't choose bachelor number three. He's a salesman. He's into tennis and jogging and skiing and baseball. Obviously a sportsman. Bill Goldstein. Billy, come on over. Yeah. I wondered, if you didn't win, if you were going to still give her the flower,
yes.
Bill.
I wasn't going to rip it up and throw it down.
Well, speaking of giving, we have gifts for both of you, and thank you for being on the show and giving us a great game. Thank you, Pee-wee. Come back again, will you? All right. All right, Carrie, you're about to come face to face with the man you chose. Let me tell you something about bachelor number one. He's a writer. He's won an Emmy and a Clio Award. He loves to skin dive, play checkers, hang glide, daring fella. Say hello to Bill Towle. Billy, come on and say hello, please.